Welcome back to another episode of Five Things. I'm John Papa.
And I'm Craig Shoemaker.
And today we're going to talk about five things about IndexedDB. Number one, what is it and why would I want to use offline data storage in the browser?
Well, often when you're building applications, you might be working offline, or maybe you just want to be able to persist data on the client without having to talk to the server all the time. And you've got about three different realistic options. You've got cookies, which have been around for eons.
Yep, I like cookies.
Everybody likes cookies, but they're super tiny, and you're always going to be sending that data to the server.
I always want more.
Don't we all? So you're always going to be sending that data to the server, and it'll come back. You have a web storage, which gives you an opportunity to save a lot more data on the client. That stays on the client, but it's really just persisting data there. You can't really query it. There's not much you can really do with it.
Right.
If you have a lot of data and you want to query it and be able to manage it much easier, then the main option is IndexedDB.
Are there any limits there with IndexedDB?
There are certain limits that are, some are browser imposed and some can be changed by the user. It depends on the browser. But I've put over 500,000 objects into an IndexedDB database and it works just fine.
Do they fit in a truck?
If you're very careful, and it has to be a blue truck.
Okay. Number two, what is the API like?
The API is actually kind of funky. It's a little strange, especially now in our world of async await and promise-based type APIs. Mm-hmm. The spec was created quite a while ago. And so when you go to use it, it's event-based. And it's just very kind of strange the way you're working with it. And sometimes errors can bubble up in ways that you might not expect. So one of the best ways to work with it, although it's a great technology, is to use a certain type of wrapper. So there's Dexy, which is a really good one, PouchDB, which is available.
They had a good song back in the 80s, Dexy's Midnight Runners?
Yeah.
All right.
Hey, Dexy, you're so fine, you're so fine. That one too.
Oh my gosh.
Everything that you do within the API is transactional. So whether you're doing a read or write type of operation, you know that's going to commit and it's going to work out really well. But the nice thing about it is that it gives you the chance to work with large amounts of data on the client, and you can search against it and you can work with it. And it's not just a simple, you know, writing a string to some place that it's tough to get to.
It's pretty easy to use actually too, isn't
it? Yeah, it is.
Yeah. Number three, what is searching like? Like, how do I get to the data?
Right, so there's a couple different options that you have available to you on how you create unique identifiers for your data. And then on top of that, you can create indexes for different aspects of the data. So depending on how you want to key things, you can go and search again it and bring back sets of data. The only thing that's, again, a little bit strange is that I think the people who wrote the spec didn't really like Valley Girls very much. Because there's like no like operator.
There's no like.
Yeah, exactly. So when you return data back, if you need to narrow it down more, you can filter it and use JavaScript operations after you've got your data back. But that's what it's going to be like, using the indexes with IndexedDB.
So get the data, then use some filtering with like array methods.
Exactly.
Okay. Number four, how do we sync data between IndexedDB and the server?
Well, it's all up to you. So you have a lot of options available. Yeah, it's the best part, right? You actually get to write some code.
Cool.
There are some strategies that you can use in order to make it more like a lift and shift type of operation. So PouchDB gives you this ability to basically build up your IndexedDB and persist it up to the server. One of the drawbacks to that is that it's really opinionated of what your server might look like. So if that's not for you, then you can do whatever you want. You could write it up to Azure Storage, you could put it on a Mongo database that's up on the server. It's basically up to you, and it gives you the chance to decide how much of that data you want to persist on the server.
So any kind of backend server could work,
right,
depending on the kind of code you want to write.
Exactly. And it is a document database, so one of the nice things about IndexedDB is we're often used to working with JSON objects, and so that makes persistence really easy. And so if you want to take that and move it up to the same type of a database on the server, that works well also.
A lot of parsing and stringifying, I assume.
Yeah, a lot.
All right. Number five, what's the browser support story like?
The browser support,
can I use it in Netscape?
Oh, of course. Well, actually, it was first implemented in Mosaic, so you can actually go all the way back.
I guess we can.
All of the major browsers support it. And in fact, the only ones who really have a little bit of trouble with it are browsers that start with IE and Edge. And really, of those, it's just a few of the low-level APIs that have difficulty with. But for the most part, your browser support is ubiquitous because the spec and the implementation has been around for quite a while.
And I've used it on mobile devices too for things like with Ionic.
Right.
So it's super powerful for offline storage, even in mobile
exactly.
web apps.
And that's one of the best use cases. I mean, if you're going to need to persist data and have it when you don't have an internet connection available, that'll work really well.
Craig, this is awesome, but if I want to get started with it, Where do I learn more?
One of the best places you can go is caniuse.com. You can see where the browser support is set up, and it has a lot of resources, links to the spec and tutorials all available right there.
Fantastic. I'm John Papa.
And I'm Craig Shoemaker.
And we just learned 5 things about IndexedDB.
Well, you did.
I didn't learn anything.
Oh, okay.
Okay.